Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess and today's video we'll be designing this logo. This logo represents the glass figure where there are multiple number of faces and each face is reflecting different range of light rays. So, and we will create this logo using the very basic tools as well as we'll create. We need to understand this part where there's a range of color, which is the blue, which is arranged from lightest to darkest and darkest to lightest. In the same way, this is also the shades of blue color, but has been arranged randomly. And you can create your own color shades with different color, but you have to select one color and create the color shade from the lightest to the darkest. And that's all. And you can, so let's begin with this. First, we'll create this logo. To create this, we'll select the ellipse tool here and draw out an ellipse. And after that, the next step is to create these points, each points, and there are multiple number of edges here, and we have only 4 points here. So we need to add more anchor points. To add anchor point to this ellipse, we'll go to Object, Path, Add Anchor Points, and this will add 4 more anchor points here. Now the next step is we'll select the Convert Anchor Point tool and just click on each anchor points, and this will make this anchor point sharp. That's pointed. So just click all the anchor points here, and after that, with the direct selection tool, you can edit the anchor points. So with the up and down arrow keys buttons, just move in and out, and just edit the shape. So just keep on editing it. Here, more upper. This one we have to move right side, so with the arrow keys just keep moving on the right side, select this point and move on the right. This one we need to take it to upper, and this one more downward, this one little bit outside, and this one more outside. So once you have got the basic shape, the next is to duplicate this. So to duplicate this one more time, we'll go to Reflect Tool, double click on it, click the vertical option, copy it. Now move it a right side, and we need to do little bit corrections here. So select the anchor points, move it to right side, this one little bit upward, this one little bit more downward, and this one little bit more like this. We need to elongate more, so select from the all this stuff and just move it a little bit downward so it's more elongated. We need to move this little bit downward. So after that, select both the object in the pathfinder, combine it, and the next step is we need to create all these faces. And to create this, we need to do one step here with the line segment tool. We will create this all the outlines here. So to do that, we'll just click and drag, and this will create the line, give it some stroke color. So do it to all the points from here till here till here. So this will automatically snap. So you need to do this, and from anchor points till here, from here till here. So keep on selecting and make all the face, this line segments here in this center. We need to create this. So just drag and make one, this one till here, and this one till here. Now from here till here, drag and just make this stuff from here till here. Now another portion is left, we'll make that. We need point here till here, draw out everything till here till here, from here to here, and just keep on drawing from the anchor points to the last edge. This will complete it from here to here. So we have done almost all the pieces we have drawn. Now the next step is to select all the strokes except the shape, deselect that and go to object, path, join. So this will create object, this will make this all the stroke as one object. And now the next step is select this stroke, go to object, path, divide below. So divide object below will divide all the pieces, and you can see that every piece is now separate. Now the next step is to fill this with color. So select this with the dice selection tool V shortcut, and with the eyedropper fill it with the color. Select this, fill it with color. Select this, fill it with color. Select this, fill it with color. This one with this. This one with this. This one with this. This one with this. This one, select this, fill this with color. Select this, fill this. Select this, fill it. Select this and fill it. In the same way, now select this portion here with the selection tool. Fill this with color. Select this. This one, 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 this one, this. This one with this color. This one with this color. This one with this color. So we have filled the colors. We have done. So it's become very easy when you have already done your color shades. We have to just prepare all the color shades of your desired color. Like I have selected the blue color and created the color shades, this one, this, and little bit of randomness here. That's all. So you have done that. Now you can see that though, the color, with the color filled, the whole object is looking like this. You can just group this up, Control G. Now you can write it. You can even edit a little bit more here. You can just go to, if you want to give some variation in colors, you can do that. Select this object, go to edit, edit color, adjust color balance. Here you can edit the color balance here. So if you want a little bit dark, you can do that. You want lighter, you can do that. If you want to change the color, you can change it to any color like green, anyone. So we'll keep it like this for that, for this tutorial. Now the next step is to write the text. To write the text here, glass glass, and with the eyedropper you can just select this one and it will be same as that and place it there. So this one, this logo we have created using the earlier tools which we have learned earlier. We're using the ellipse tool and the line segment tool, and the thing which were the most important thing which we have done is by joining all the strokes and then dividing it by using the divide below option. So this is how we can create this logo, and hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can click the subscribe button. Thank you.